Hey everyone, this is the first video that will be streamed and edited entirely over my home network via my new Homelab NAS build. If you watched that video, then firstly, kudos to you because it was 45 minutes long, so thanks for watching. But my main point is that you will have noticed in that video that I'm running plain Linux Debian on my new NAS. This build has two 4TB NVMe drives, giving 8TB of storage space for my video content, and I'm exposing this to my workstation PC and my laptop via Samba, which allows me to mount network drives on Windows and use these for editing as though the video files were stored directly on my PC. But here's the thing, there are loads of good ready-made NAS solutions out there like TrueNAS, Unraid and OpenMediaVault. So why did I go it alone and just use Debian and Samba and configure everything myself? And since I built a NAS and I put two drives in it, I definitely used RAID, right? Right? Well, no, actually, because I'm a mad lad who likes losing all of his files. Kidding. Sort of. So in this video, I wanted to cover those two points. Firstly, why didn't I use TrueNAS or similar? Why do I have zero disk redundancy? So TrueNAS, OpenMediaVault and Unraid offer some really useful features. And the first two options are free too, so why didn't I just use them? Well, let's start off with Unraid. It's clearly a powerful bit of software offering a range of features, a really nice UI and various file systems including both ZFS and XFS. I'll touch on ZFS later in this video, but XFS would have actually been perfect for me for my media server NAS due to how well it supports large files. However, Unraid comes at a big cost. Literally, they recently moved to a new license model and I'd need to pay at least $49 for a license, and this would only give me OS updates for 1 year. That means that over 4 years, I'd end up paying almost $200. And while good quality software is worth paying for, I kind of feel I'd be better off just going with Synology and getting free OS updates for life compared to paying for Unraid. Next up, we have TrueNAS and OpenMediaVault. Now, both of these are really powerful with a range of great features, including lots of disk redundancy options, basically allowing you to group different drives together and share the data in such a way that if one drive fails, you don't then lose all of your files. They both offer GUIs too, allowing you to easily get information on your NAS and how it's doing, and also make modifications to the config. In terms of the file systems, TrueNAS offers ZFS, which is much better than the default ext4 file system of Linux, since ZFS offers a wider range of advanced management features, including pool scrubbing, datasets, and snapshots. OMV doesn't offer ZFS, although it does offer XFS support, which would arguably be better for me, since it's just as advanced as ZFS, but XFS supports larger media files like video content better too. Now that all sounds pretty awesome, right? I mean, who doesn't need ZFS, pool scrubbing, and XFS extent-oriented organization? Well, me. I'll discuss ZFS more in a second, but all I really wanted with my Homelab NAS was a simple place to store my media files. I wanted a simple way of having backups sent to an offsite location, and I wanted to be able to expose my media files over the network via a Windows share. All of these are simple to do with just a straight Debian and Samba install. Debian helps me to achieve the first two objectives that I mentioned because it's easy and it just works, whereas Samba is often really simple. You just install the package via apt, add a few lines of configuration files to the bottom of the Samba config file, and then you can just jump over to Windows and you can easily access your files when adding a network volume. It's simple and it works really well. I don't need anything extra. Naturally, if I wanted to do a build with 12 data disks and I wanted to group them and rate them in weird and wonderful ways, then an all-in-one solution like TrueNAS, OMV, or Unraid would be a massive help, of course. But I mainly want to have super fast storage for my media files and then expose this over the network. I'm happy just to keep it simple. Now, you could argue that I'm missing out on some really neat features like snapshots, and that is sort of true, even though my NVMe drives are formatted as NTFS, so I could potentially use Microsoft Shadow Copy if I booted it into Windows, I guess. But the neat thing with TrueNAS and OMV is that you can easily click a button and freeze your files in time, allowing you to then roll back to that state in the future if you wanted. The great thing with ZFS and XFS snapshots is it doesn't really take up any extra disk space either, because it doesn't clone the entire disk content. It just remembers how your files were stored, and then it keeps track of file changes after that point. This means that if you had any major problems, you could just click a button and move your file system state back to that original point, which is really neat. Snapshots have a lot of potential benefits, but not necessarily for me. I mean, when I shoot a video like this one, I'll have a few large video files, MP4s, then I'll go out and collect B-roll for it. I'll also have the Premiere Pro project files. These go in a date-based folder so that I can find them in the future, and that's about it. Once the video is done, I move on to the next one. So it's very unlikely that I'll actually say, hey, let's roll back to a month ago when I didn't have those five other video projects stored. I wouldn't really need that. The only time when Snapshot might be useful for me is when I'm actually doing the video editing, because it's really easy to accidentally do the wrong thing and wipe out a bunch of your tracks. However, Premiere Pro actually frequently saves your project files in a backup folder, so I can easily go back to a previous project state by loading up that file, and then I can just copy the tracks back over or whatever I need to do. So again, I don't really need Snapshot technologies here either. Yes, ZFS and XFS do have other nice benefits too, including checksums, which help to prevent data corruption due to bad drives. However, all my files are stored in offsite locations too, plus checksums and similar features can actually slow down read and write performances a little bit, and I want the fastest possible speeds since I'm relying on my Homelab NAS for video editing. So while I think that TrueNAS, OMV and Unraid offer some really awesome benefits, they just seem a bit overkill for my purposes. They're much better for people with multiple drives who want seamless redundancy options, in my opinion. If I'm missing something though, please do let me know down in the comments before I lose terabytes of my hard work. Hopefully that doesn't happen though. Ah, Raid. Raid is love, Raid is life. Raid is the GOAT. At least according to some people online. And it is true that Raid brings a number of benefits, which is actually why I run my Synology NAS in RAID 1 mode, so that if one of my hard drives fails, I don't immediately lose all of my personal files and CCTV recordings. So if you've never heard of RAID before, here's a 30-second explanation. By buying two data drives, you can group them together so the data is replicated on both drives. This is known as RAID 1, and if one drive fails, it's no major issue because all your files are still on the other drive. This means that you can easily buy another drive, swap out the bad drive, and then all your files get synced back over in the background, meaning you're then automatically back to having two copies of your data again. This is known as data redundancy, and it's really important for servers and NASes, unless you're a mad lad like me. Kidding. While RAID 1 and the other forms like RAID 5, 6, and 10 are pretty useful, there's one big downside to it. You need multiple drives. If you want to have 4 TB of usable disk space to store all your files on, you then need to actually buy two drives and group them together, and you're then effectively losing one of those NVMe drives, in my case. Okay, you're not actually losing it, because the second drive is protecting against data loss, which is important. But in my case, I want to have as many NVMe drives as possible to give me as much total storage capacity as possible. With a PCI Express to M.2 adapter, I could probably have 4 NVMe drives in my build for 16 TB of super fast storage. Or I could RAID them up and then go down to 8 or 12 TB of storage, depending on which RAID method I use. Basically, I'm losing key storage capacity by using RAID. And here's the thing, RAID is not a backup, everyone will tell you that. If you want to make sure that your files are safe, even if you have a house fire for example, then you need offsite backups. RAID won't protect against a house fire, of course. So what I'm doing with my Homelab NAS is ensuring that my files are backed up to my Hetzner backup area at least once a day. This works better for me than RAID, to be honest. Yes, I would lose some files if my NVMe drive died before the backup job actually run, but the video content I shot would still be on my SD cards, so I could just retrieve it from there instead. In that sense, since I'm using my Homelab NAS for video content, I do actually have data redundancy via my SD cards, and then I have data protection through my offsite backup space. And that's good enough for me. The alternative would be to spend loads of money on really expensive NVMe drives and then lose half of this space for no real benefit. My Homelab NAS is now fully operational, which I'm really excited about. If you didn't see the build, then you can check out here, and while it is 45 minutes long, admittedly it has lots of chapters, you can jump around and see the bits of the video that interest you. But that wraps up this video, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.